Yo everybody and welcome back to this video. Today we're gonna take a look at the Sadboys and Drain Gang tier list. So I'm gonna be ranking pretty much every album or project from these guys, both the Sadboys group and Drain Gang. Personally, I kinda think it's a bit done too much, this tier list, but you guys wanted it, so here it is. Also, I'm gonna try to explain the reason I'm giving it the rank I'm giving it, instead of like just being like I like this, so therefore it's this. But I'm gonna try to have a more good reasoning. Also, I'll just like to explain like what an S means to me. An S rank to me is like perfect. It is the masterpiece. It's like no skips on the album. It's just, and all the songs are like, they're banging. So yeah, that's an S for me. An A is just like very fucking good. B the same. C is just like decent. And D is just like, it's kinda eh. And F is just like, I don't like that shit. Also, some of these albums, I would say my opinion on them is still kind of, you know, I haven't really found my opinion on it yet because I haven't listened to it enough. It's like a whole lot of red from Playboi Carti I still haven't found my footing on. Some of these albums, I'm gonna tell which ones it is, but most of them I have formed an opinion on. Let's just start with Plastic Surgery from Blade. So this is one of those albums like I kinda haven't gotten into yet. I mean, I have listened through it a couple times I think, but off the top of my mind I think it's like, it's good. I'd say it's good. It's probably a B. You know, it's more Blade. Some of the songs pretty catchy, you know. It Sucks, Plastic Surgery, you know. There are some pretty good songs. Yeah, it's pretty good. Next one is Jonathan Lindor's Cutler. So this is an, I guess it's in project like EP or something from Jonathan, where he like makes R&B music. And it's kind of a project I haven't really gotten into yet. I mean, I haven't listened through it. I listened through it real quick when I was about to make this video. So yeah, I can only say I'm not sure on this one. Next one is Young Sherman, Innocence. This is an instrumental project. I have listened to it a couple of times, but I'm not really into like instrumental albums. It's not really anything I listen to, so I really can't give my own opinion on this. You know, I could say it's not for me, but honestly I think other people would do it more justice. Innocence 2, also from Young Sherman, is just like the first one. I really can't give my opinion on it. I'd like to, but it's instrumentals and I don't really listen to it. I don't really find it that enjoying. Maybe in the future I'll make an update with my new views on these albums, but yeah. Working on Dying from Blade and Working on Dying. This album goes way too hard. Like, the beats on it is just, they're fucking amazing. Like, Working on Dying's what they did to these beats, and just like they collab with White Armor on them, they're so hard. And Blade, he goes hard on everyone too. We got features like Black Cray, you know, we got one of the best flows I've ever heard from Young Lena and Cherry Bracelets. Like, this for me, this album is no skips. It's, yeah, it couldn't be more perfect. I love it. I know it's kind of an mixed album. People they sleep on it way too much. It's just great. Dødmark from Young Lean, his punk band. I don't listen to punk at all, so for me this album was, I think Travis Scott said it best on the radio show with Young Lean.
I'm catching the second wave, dude.
But the second wave could be almost as good as the first one.
That wasn't it. For people who listen to punk, this actually may be pretty fucking good. I don't know, so therefore I'm not gonna, you know, put it on anywhere here. If it was up to me, it would be the lower ranks, but yeah, I'm just gonna say not sure. Glue from Blade. So, I think Glue is a pretty loved project, but I love this project way too much. I think it's perfect. it's very dreamy, and you know, the old Blade, I really love his stuff, you know, when he was talking about swords and playing video games and magic. It's that time was too fire, and I think just Glue is a perfect showing of this. So I really love this album, but I think there are some places on this album where you could say the beats, I mean, they're good, but he used other producers than Drain Gang producers, and I don't know, some of the tracks just don't hit that hard, which is kind of sad, but I still love it because, I mean, that song is like, for me, a personal song that's way too underrated is Spellbound. Like, goddamn, that shit hits way too hard. Also, the music video, damn. Delete-y, you know, that shit gets us up over the clouds. I want to give it S, but sadly, there are just a few songs on there that, I don't know, I don't really fuck with. So, it's gonna be an A. E from Echo 2K. Now, I know everyone would just say, easy S, you know, give the highest ranking because it's fucking Echo and it's E, and Anthony Fantano gave it probably the highest. It's probably the Drain Gang album with the highest ranking from Fantano. But for me, I mean, I'm kinda in the middle, you know. I don't think it's bad at all. I think it's amazing too. But it's not like I think every song is good. There are a few songs where I'm like, this isn't really for me. But in general speaking, I love this album too, and therefore it's an A for me. Stranger from Young Lean. I love it. I really love it. But it's just a Young Lean album I really haven't gone through yet. I'm a very big Young Lean fan, almost bigger than Drain Gang. But Stranger, I'm still kinda in the middle on. You know, I want to say like everyone else, it's his best project. Again, it's the highest rated Young Lean project from Fantano, but for me, that doesn't mean it's an S, you know. It is great, it is good, you know, but I personally can't give it an S. I'll probably stick to an A. It's very good, you know. It got bangers, and production is great, but personally, I'm the guy who likes the older Young Lean music more than his newer stuff, though I do like his new stuff. But it's not to hate on it, but it gets an A. GTB SG compilation. This is a compilation filled with old songs from Drain Gang, and I love the old stuff. Like, it is banging. But you know, I could see why a person would put it down here in the lower sides, because the production has come a far way since then, and the vocal mixing on some of the songs and mic quality is just, it's pretty bad. But it's also a time where you can clearly listen that some of Ty Boy's songs wasn't that evolved yet, but I still love it, still think it got some of the best classics from Drain Gang ever, and therefore it's an A for me. It kind of reminds me of Glue, you know, kind of the same thing. Frost Guard, I think, Frost Guard by Young Lean is an Young Lean album I also really haven't gotten into. I've listened through it multiple times, but I think the only one that stands for me are like Hennessy and Sailor Moon and Crystal City. That kind of fucked me up because I got a song with the same name. Wasn't intentional. But they're pretty much the only two songs I like. It's just an Young Lean album that kind of disappointing. It's not bad by any means, you know. Production is good and Young Lean is pretty good too. But for me, it's just decent. Like, the most of the songs just aren't that good. Or catchy, if you could say that. Red Light by Blade. So, I think we all know Red Light is a goddamn banger. Red Light is, it's A, you know, it's nothing to say about it. Red Light, it's just some of the best Blade work ever. I don't think every song hits too hard, so it's not an S. I sure would see why one would put it. Young Lean, Unknown Death. So, I love the old Jung Lean. When I discovered Jung Lean, Ginseng Strip, this was the shit I found, you know, listening to Gatorade and Hurt. In the start, I didn't really like every song, but with time, I have really come to appreciate every single song. I love this album way too much. And for me, there are no skips. It's a perfect encapsulation of internet rap, like, and that's personally what I love. I love that shit. So for me, it's an S. Psychopath ballads. Yeah, it's another R&B project by Jung Lean, and this one I have listened through. Psychopath ballads, I think, is pretty mixed. I have two songs from it that I like, and I think you all know which ones: Hotel in Minsk and Never Go Again, I think it's called. The rest of it is, it's just not that good. But there are a few songs that's okay, but in general, I don't really think it hits too hard. There are only two songs I like. Don't really fuck with it, but it's not the worst. Trash Island from Drain Gang. Yeah, it's a banger. We all know it. It's still an album, I think. I would love to have it to grow more on me, because right now I still don't think some of the songs I really haven't like fully, you know, how much do I don't know, it's weird. I just don't know how much I love it, but for me it is an easy A. Maybe in the future it would be an S, but now it's A, and I think it's pretty good ranking. Good or Young Good. This is another instrumental album. And as you know, with Young Sherman, I don't really... The only instrumental track I actually have listened to is My Stomach is a Lion from Good. And that one I think is very good, but... very good. But in general speaking, I just don't think I should rank this. Yeah. So I'm just gonna say not sure. AVP by Tyboy and Blady. It's kind of underrated. Let me just say it. It's kind of underrated. It's pretty fucking good. What can I say? It's kind of banging. Though again, I would say it's not my favorite. There are a couple of songs that's just like, it's all right. But I'm gonna give it a B. It's good. It's a pretty good album. And if you haven't listened to it, or think that it's probably trash, fucking listen to it. And Area 51, like, whoo, Crush Resist EP. This is pretty experimental. It's like industrial noise type of thing. Funny enough, I actually do listen to Death Grips, and so I feel like I should be able to rank this, because it's kind of the same lane. But for me, some of this just, it gets a bit too much, like the noise. It's some of the tracks, it's kind of overwhelming to the point where you really kind of can't listen to it. But some of the tracks also have like these pretty good sounds in the background. But for me, I wouldn't listen to it, but I love its artistic expression, and for that reason I'm gonna give it a decent. It may be sound weird, but I like, when I go into this album and just look at it, I'm like, wow, this is an amazing album, like visual looking and conceptual. But when you listen to it, Triple Three by Blade is pretty fucking... In the start, I was kind of like, trash. Not exactly what, right, but I had to give it some time to grow on me. But now it's just at a point where I actually like every song on it. It's amazing, like driving in the summer and just listening to Triple Three, you know, in the sunset or some shit. I don't know, there's something over it. It's very fucking good. And for me, it's just, it's no skips. So Triple Three isn't... It's Ness, boys. It's Ness. And girls. Forget Lord of the Jewels, Tyboy Digital. This shit is it's pretty banging, you know. I like the idea, like, it's very drill inspired. Like, Drain Gang becomes drill, and that's kind of cool, you know. You also got some cool features like Black Cray. We all love that guy. But some of the production quality is... It's kind of low. The only songs I really fuck with is Fucked Up and Ball Alert. It's not many, and it's not even because, like, Tyboy's vocals, they're pretty rough. And in general speaking, this album, it's pretty rough. Even the cover for it, it's just like fucking Sadboys' face edited shit in on Akira, the anime, and just fucking Sadboy digital all over and Lord of the Jewels. Yeah, I don't know. It's kind of rough album, but I like the idea about it. You should definitely check it out if you haven't listened to it. But you're not gonna find your favorite Sadboy on it. DJ Billy motherfucking Bool. DJ Billy Bool is easy as. Now, if we're speaking memes though, this album is great. But yeah, the only shit I really like about it is Full Moon. Full Moon is kind of a banger. And the intro is just, it's legendary. No, legendary, remember? But yeah, I don't really like EDM or like, it's kind of a disco club banger and it's kind of weird. So I don't know, like I kind of love it, but then again, not really. So I'm just gonna say decent, you know. It's it is what it is, but I don't really listen to EDM, so in general I don't. Only sometimes I'm just like, yeah, fuck it, let's hit the Full Moon. SOS is also an album I really haven't listened to too much. I have skipped through it a couple times, you know. The biggest song of it, Magic, I don't really even like. The production is, it's pretty good production, and it, you know, Sadboys' vocals are pretty clear this time, so I think it's some of his better work, but again, it's pretty EDM, kinda, like, kinda disco vibes you get from it, and I don't know, it's a weird mix between cloud rap and sometimes a little bit of EDM. So for me, it's decent, I guess. I don't listen too much to it, but I wouldn't say it's bad. It's decent. Nectar from Jonathan Lindor. 17, can't forget it. Nectar, I really don't like. There's nothing about it I like. Luckily, I do listen to R&B, but I don't even know if this is categorized as it. I really don't like it. There's not one single track I like. And all the tracks I just listened to, it's like, I don't know, it's pretty rough. Yeah, it don't really have any redeeming qualities. For me, isn't it? Unknown Memory from Young Lean. Unknown Memory is banging. We all know it. It's one of Young Lean's best projects. I wouldn't say it's an S. I don't like every song on it. There's intermissions and intros and outros, and as cool as it is, they're not really that good and interesting to listen to. And very few of the tracks isn't that good, but you know, in general speaking, it is filled with bangers. And also, we got a Travis Scott feature on there. Can't forget it. So that's very fucking cool. In general speaking, this album is amazing. It is amazing. But not in this. Oh, fuck. Lavender from Young Lean. Yeah, this album, though, that's in this. Also, these pictures, they aren't in order. So it's not like Glue is the best A project. No, it's random. Lavender, it's... Whew! That shit is fire. You know, we got Oreo Milkshake, the banger. We got Ginseng Strip. We got Grey Goose, which is slept on way too much. That Enya sample is so hard. So this album is great. I don't care what you say. It's also a perfect encapsulation. Fuck it, I'ma search this word up. It's also a perfect encapsulation of internet rap. But I don't know if Def is a bit better at it, but Lavender is great. Ever Since, we all know it. Don't need to say anything. It's the classic, the OG, the classic Drain Gang album. Warlord, from, well, I think we're speaking the deluxe, of course, but from Young Lean. This album is great. The album got crazy story behind it. Wicked bangers like Hoover, Miami Ultras, and Afghanistan, and in general speaking, this album, it's an S for me. I think you noticed, but I don't got any skips on this album. Slept On tracks also, Eye Contact, Shine, and Stars Line. Way too slept on. Stars from Young Lean. It's a great new album he released, and filled with a lot of bangers. It's sad we didn't get the Playboi Carti feature, but you know, yeea was still banging. And I actually think this is some of Young Lean's better work, you know. It's really, really fucking good. So therefore, I will give it an A. I think it has some skips, but in general speaking, I think it's a really good album. Really good. And production is high, and it also features some of the best lyrics from Young Lean. Stranger does too, I will say. Legendary member from Tyboy Digital. This album is banging too. It's one of the best Tyboy albums. I don't know if it's underrated per se, but it's pretty good. Though I will say it's not every song on it that I really fuck with. Some of the songs I think are quite kind of stale, but in general it's pretty good. It got some of the best Tyboy songs. For me, it's a B. It's not an A because I think there's a little too many skips on it. But it is good. It is a very good album. But like Legendary Member and Lip Service, Nervous, they are some of the only songs I can think of off the top of my head that I really fuck with on it. So, yeah. D&G is also a very good Drain Gang album. Though it was kind of tough to get into when I started listening to it, because I don't know if it's just me, but I felt like there was pretty many songs. Like, if you just sat and listened through it, some of the songs just blended together. Like, they almost sounded the same, which is kind of sad, I think, but they're still pretty good songs, you know. I will give it A. There aren't many skips on it for me. I really fuck with a lot of the songs. Ice Dancer. This is an album. It's almost S for me, but much like Red Light, it sits just right under. But it's really fucking good. Poison Ivy from Young Lean. I like Poison Ivy a lot, actually. It was when I first discovered Young Lean, like when I started listening to him, I listened to his song Friday the 13th. And then I listened to Jing Tang Strip, and I was like, nah, his newer music is trash. I didn't like it one bit. I felt like that shit was F. But now I have, you know, listened to all of his music, and yeah, I'm a pretty big fan, and with time I have actually learned to appreciate it. And it is actually a no-skip album from me. There's not really one song I really don't fuck with. The thing is, all of the songs on the project are just, to me, they're good, but they're not that good. Like, it's just some mediocre songs, I would say. But they are certainly banging. I'd give it an A for being very good. You know, you can listen to it and it's all gonna be pretty good. But if you don't fuck with the newer Young Lean, it's, yeah, you're not gonna like it that much. And that was my problem in the start, but now I do like this new stuff. Tiger from Tyboy Digital. This album is so slept on. It's crazy. The production on this album is some of the best work from Drain Gang ever. It is perfect. It's so crazy. Like, I'm just gonna say it. No skips. ECS. The way when you start the album, the melody from Haters Broke just slowly flows in on the song, and you just sit there, and then the drop fucking hits, and you just like, yeah, hell yeah, all my haters are fucking broke. Yeah, you just feel it. And then you get Diamonds featuring Young Lean, which is also perfect, and GTB Let's Go with Blade on, you know, that shit it's hard as well. And Shadow Silence drop is just, it's banging. It is so good. And yeah, you could say, well, Tyboy is rapping on it. It's not that great, but I don't know. That was my problem when I started listening to it as well. Like, well, Tyboy isn't, I don't know, he didn't really deliver as much as I would have him to deliver. But by time, like, I just appreciate it. I just love the thing that Tyboy is doing on it. He's just doing himself, just flowing on the track and just not giving a fuck and just doing him. And I just sit there and go like, yeah, fuck yeah, Tyboy, do this shit again. And he just spits. R.I.P. Blade. This album got 50 Sag in my sock, I don't give a fuck. We all know that shit's banging. Butterfly with Tyboy as well. Whew, that shit goes hard. Blade's flow on it.
One touch will affect you. Insect crew, venom I infect you.
Yeah. But the rest of the album for me now is kind of, it's an album I want to give, you know, listen to a bit more, because I don't think I have my full perspective on it yet, but as of now it's filled with bangers. But yeah, there are some songs that kind of miss. It's not that they're bad, it's just like they're kind of decent, so very good and decent, and it's a B. Exeter is, it's tough for me as well. When Exeter came out, I was like, I don't like this. I was just like, this is doll music, like dollhouse music. I don't know. It sounded so weird, some of the beats on it. It was just like, it was very hard for me to get into. But as time has passed on, wouldn't you see it? It has evolved and grown on me a lot, and I really have come to quite like this album. I wouldn't say it's the best Blade album, but it's certainly very, very good. Though I still don't like every song on it, but I like most of the album. I'd say it's a pretty good album. The most underrated song on it, though, I don't care. It's Every Moment Special. Like the vocal sample on it, like when it starts, it's so good. I don't know how that song isn't getting more attention, but you know, it is what it is. But yeah, it's a B from me. This is my list. You know, look forward to reading some comments that are mad as fuck on my opinion. But you know, it is my opinion, and yeah, I probably know a lot of people are not gonna agree. But you know, in general, I think I pretty much like every single, almost every album from Drain Gang. There are a few that, you know, the decent ones. Some of them I haven't really gone through yet. But in general, yeah, of course I have listened to them. Next video is probably gonna be a rapper iceberg, so look forward to that, cause, and test your rapper knowledge. But I think this is everything from me, so thanks for watching.